If you're like me, you've probably seen a ton of memes online making this point that because of COVID-19, pollution levels are down. We've seen images of the Venice canals that are now clear. We've seen pictures of people seeing Himalayan mountains for the first time in 30 years. And yes, while pollution is down in the short term, this pandemic is nothing to celebrate. There have been over 1.9 million cases globally, and over 110,000 people have lost their lives because of this. In addition to that, our entire economy and our entire society has been turned upside down because of this crisis. I'm curious to understand how this crisis that we're going through right now will impact how we address climate change moving forward. So I've decided to reach out to two experts to really get their take on what they think will happen. First up, I'm gonna talk to Gernot Wagner, who is a climate economist and political scientist. And later, I'm gonna talk to Leah Stokes, who is a climate policy expert. I'm Lucy Biggers, and this is One Small Step. So it is true that at least temporarily, the environment seems to be doing well because of the economic slowdown caused by the COVID-19 response. The Global Carbon Project estimates that this year, carbon emissions will be down by about 5% globally. But scientists still warn that we need to act now and create the structural changes that will draw down CO2 and set us up to really address climate change.
The main narrative that we're seeing online with the sharing of these memes is like, pollution is down, like, yay. And can you tell me why that's not the right response?
Air pollution is down. Yes, that is good. And for air pollution, it may actually have health effects that are actually good for climate. A proper climate response means more action. It means more investment. It means more deployment of new technologies. It doesn't mean going back to our caves.
Instead of this idea of do less, shrink the economy, we should be instead investing more in changing it.
Exactly, right? Basically, climate change means action. It means the right kind of action, but it's still action. It is not going back, do nothing, do less of. It takes institutions like the IPCC. It takes guidance, it takes government, it takes policy to guide us in the right direction, right? Simply relying on crashing our society, our economy, social, physical distancing, right, isn't going to decrease CO2 emissions, certainly not sustainable.
So people are comparing and being like, oh, this is a crisis, and like the climate is a crisis. What's the biggest differences between the two?
Well, frankly, the biggest difference is the timescale. Right? With COVID, just everything happened very, very quickly, right? If, you know, things double every 2 or 3 days, well, a 1 day time difference matters a lot. That's just not the case with climate, right? Sort of delaying that meeting by another year isn't going to immediately fry the planet. Of course, the problem is these underlying forces, right? Exponential growth. They are needing to be collective action, government policy, to actually guide us in the right direction. All of these are parallels. They are. The difference, of course, is if we don't act on climate today, we see the consequences in a decade. When we don't act on COVID today, well, we see cases doubling in 2 days. So yes, we need to get back to taking science facts seriously when it comes to science policy. And frankly, get ready for the next pandemic, for climate change, for problems where we know we need to rely on smart policy to make a difference.
President Trump recently signed a $2 trillion economic stimulus package that will put money into the hands of American individuals and keep businesses afloat. But nothing in that bill included any measures to address climate change. And that's why people like climate policy expert Leah Stokes are arguing that if there's another government relief bill, it should be something like a green stimulus that can not only put Americans back to work, but also address climate change while we're at it.
Do you think that, considering everything we're going through, and there's obviously going to be a lot of money spent by the government, that this is an opportunity to pass something like a green stimulus package?
We have to decide if we want to come out of this crisis in the same 20th century society that we went into it in. We have to be investing in green infrastructure, cleaning up our electricity system, our transportation system, our buildings, and this is a big opportunity to do it. If we're going to use a lot of federal money to inject it into the economy, let's rebuild the economy. Let's make it safer and healthier for everybody, because Here's the thing. New research is showing that air pollution is actually making coronavirus more deadly. Then air pollution is another thing that we really have to get on top of. And rather than doing that, what is Trump doing during this pandemic? He's rolling back auto emission standards, which is literally going to kill more people.
We've already spent $2 trillion, and I think a few weeks ago that would have been unimaginable. Do you think we could spend less than that to get the climate results that we want to see with our current economy?
You know, rebuilding our economy is actually a really hopeful and positive thing. If we put money into jobs, whether that's, you know, getting electric vehicles built, getting wind turbines put into place, building transmission lines, retrofitting homes so that we don't have to use natural gas to burn our homes. These are not disruptive, tragic things to do. They are really positive things that can give people good paying jobs, meaningful work. In fact, if we're facing something like 10 to 20% unemployment in the coming months, which is crazily possible, why wouldn't we try to think about putting people back to work in new industries? And no, it won't be about sacrifice and, sadness. People in the fossil fuel industry and the electric utility industry want you to be sad about climate change. They want you to feel like it's hopeless, that there's nothing we can do, and that it's all about your individual carbon footprint.
If you were in power right now, what would be the steps that you would take to get some of these policies through? What would be the most important step that you would take right now?
So the most important policy that we can pass federally, and that's what we really need. We need federal laws. The first thing that I would do is I would pass a clean electricity standard. If we clean up our electricity system, that allows us to do two other things: clean up our transportation sector and clean up our buildings. And if we did what I just described, we would be 70% of the way towards reducing our carbon emissions to zero. So this is not an impossible task. It's really about setting the rules of the road, putting standards in place, getting investment on the table to actually start changing our economy.
What is one small step that people who are watching this video can take?
The one thing you can do is talk about the climate crisis.
It was so great to talk to Gernot and Leah and really break through some of the noise around COVID and climate. Because in the end of the day, these crises are so different, but there are a lot of parallels. And I think my biggest hope after talking to them and understanding this better is that one day we will be able to see the Himalayan mountains. We will be able to have clean canals in Venice, and that will be because of our innovation and our investment in green technology, and not because some virus brought our entire world to a halt. If you guys like this video, please share it. Please contact your local representatives and your state and federal representatives around pushing for a green stimulus bill. And next time you can, please vote. Vote through the mail, vote in person, just vote, vote, vote. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being part of my video. Mwah. And we'll see you guys next time.
Oh my gosh, wait a minute. That giraffe hasn't been seen in my parents' yard in over 30 years. Nature is healing.